This is the latest reconnaissance from the Siegfried Line. Now that Montgomery's attempt at a shortcut has failed, we're going to have to get through Germany the hard way. This is the Moselle River near Metz. And this is Fort Schmerzen, which is proving to be one tough nut to crack. Thick concrete walls, artillery, machine gun emplacements, dragon's teeth. It's a briar patch of German defenses. Now, what you see in the recon is only the tip of the iceberg. These forts go incredibly deep, sometimes 4 or 5 levels down into the earth. They're completely self-sustaining. They have their own command and control centers, radio rooms, supply bays, dormitories, and kitchens. Jerry can stay down there for weeks, even months at a time. And of all these fortifications, Schmerzen is the biggest of the lot. While we've been able to knock out some of the smaller forts, Schmerzen has remained impenetrable. They keep pouring resources of men and equipment into it, even though it doesn't make much tactical sense now that we can effectively flank the position. Unless, that is, something sinister is going on down there that we don't know about. And that is what is scaring us. I'll be honest with you, son. You're not the first agent we've tried to send in there. But it's imperative that we find out what the Germans are up to, so that's why I've personally assigned you this mission. The Nazis are hiding something deep inside Fort Schmerzen, and my gut tells me it's something bad.
Waffe runter!
Thank you.
ihn!
Thank you.
Waffe runter!
Alle Offiziere!
Ein Armee!
Fucking Americana!
Okay, I'm gonna go.
Danke, in Amerikaner!
Achtung, Landkanal. Die Offiziersquartiere können jetzt gesäubert werden.
Stücke! entre vous.
Let's go.
kill you again!
Come on!
Along with tanks and artillery, a key ingredient of the 1939 Blitzkrieg was the Stuka dive bomber. Its powerful cannons could rip through any piece of armor, and the Stuka's telltale whistle as it dove towards its target became as powerful a psychological weapon as any of its explosive bombs. Goering and Hitler's success with the Stuka, however, would be short-lived. The Allied air forces would soon gain superiority of the skies.